You know, I went to Bangu in 1958. I was not quite 17 years old, and I had a duffel bag in this hand and my $33 harmony guitar over the other, and I'm walking towards a bunkhouse, and one of the young women, who was young girls, young women, said, "Hey, Elvis, wait for me." And that, all summer long, was, they called me Elvis, eh? But my big, I'm just going to give you a little bit of my big hit in Namu. It wasn't an Elvis song. It was called the Bartender Song. Since then, I don't need bartenders anymore, but I remember a chorus and a verse. And the last verse blames it all on women, which is not going to be very popular in this day and age. But here's the one. If I meet somebody who really knew me from a long time ago in Namu, they'll say, "Sing the Bartender Song." I'm like, "That's right, bartender, I broke that glass. Well, it caused any trouble, so please let it pass. She broke my heart like that glass on the floor. No thanks, bartender, I don't want any more. Now someday a man may walk into this tavern, and it may break one of your glasses on the wall. But don't you call him just a common drunkard, for chances are that a woman caused it all." Don't throw any good tomatoes. "That's right, bartender, I broke that glass. No, I won't cause any trouble, so please let it pass. She broke my heart like that glass on the floor. No thanks, bartender, I don't want any more. No thanks, bartender, I sure don't want any more. Why me, Lord, what have I ever done to deserve even one of the pleasures I've known? Tell me, Lord, what did I ever do that was worth love from you and the kindness you've shown?" Help me out here, okay? "Lord, help me, Jesus, I've wasted. Nice to be in Port Hardy. I was raised in a little place called Pender Harbor on the Sunshine Coast. When I'm on Salt Spring, I have to tell them, no, it's not Pender Island, it's Pender Harbor. And loggers and fishermen back then, I'm sure a lot of you know what I'm talking about. And I always wanted to play the guitar and sing, but I started out with the violin. And one day we got some new neighbors, and they came down from Jarvis Inlet. And they brought two houses and floated them in at high tide, and drug them up on the shore, and yippee, we had two brand new neighbors in Granny Reed's orchard. And one of them's name was Red Nicholson, and he's the guy who taught me how to play the guitar, and I wrote this for him. True story. We lived in a house at the head of a tidewater bay. Then you and your family moved in beside us one day. You floated your house in and then dragged it up on the shore. And when I was 14, you taught me my very first chords. Oh, I'd listen to parties when you sang those old cowboy songs. Well, you were like the late Jimmy Hank Snow and Will Fall in one. Yes, you were. I'd play my old fiddle, try to stay in tune with you, but I knew that I'd have to pick guitar, sing those songs too. So sing to me, yodeling, yodeling, yodeling. You'll always be a saltwater cowboy to me. Yes, sing to me, yodeling, yodeling, yodeling. Cowboy to me. Red, he was an outspoken man, sort of like my wife, I guess. You always spoke justice, the opinions you held, they were strong. And when I went haywire on liquor, he said it was wrong. Sailed the White Arrow through the Straits broad and narrow. You love a big spring on the line. That's a salmon, you know, I don't have to say that up here. But you'll always be old friend, cowboy song mentor of mine. So sing me, yodeling, yodeling, yodeling. Sidekick, he's riding through this box canyon. And in the movie, he figured Roy was dead. Somebody had shot him. Bad guys, obviously, right? All of a sudden, this beautiful yodel comes through the canyon. So, of course, it's Roy. He's not dead. So that's the first yodel. Then I go on to, how many of you remember the late Jimmy Rogers, who died in 1933? All right. Then I go on to a yodel that was, try to be like the late Jimmy. But then in the 50s, there was a guy named Elton Britt, another guy named Kenny Rogers. And they did kind of a hybrid between Swiss and cowboy yodeling. So this is what's going to happen now, I think. Here comes Roy.
Thank you.